Sign convention in optics is very important concept. So after all, why sign convention? To have the relevant formula for the lenses or the mirrors, we must apply these sign conventions. Now let us discuss the new Cartesian sign conventions. In this, all the distances are measured from the pole in the case of mirrors, and in the case of lenses, all the distances will be measured from the optical center. Now, this is a concave surface, and then this is a convex surface. Now the distances are to be taken from the pole. Suppose if the light is incident in one particular direction, then we have to take the direction of the light as positive. The measurements that are taken in the direction of incident light is always positive. For example, in this case, the light is moving from my left to right. So this is the direction. So in this direction, whatever the measurements I'll take, all are to be considered as positive. Now, if I go opposite to this direction, then negative. So these direction are positive, and the measurements that are taken in these directions are negative. Similarly, when we take the upward directions, they are all positive, and downward directions all are negative. Now, suppose if I keep an object on the left side of this mirrors, any of the two mirrors, then the light rays will be in this direction towards the mirror. Now, if I wanted to take the distance between the pole and object, I have to go in this direction. Therefore, as I am going opposite to the light direction, my U, the distance between object and the pole, is negative. Now suppose if the image is formed on the same side of the object, then V is also negative. Suppose if the image is formed behind the mirror, then I have to go and measure this direction. As it is in the direction of light, it should be considered as positive. So now U is always negative. In any case, now V is negative for real images and positive for virtual images. Now, F, the focal length, is positive for convex surfaces, and the focal length is negative for concave surfaces. Now you see, suppose this is the first one is concave surface. The focal length and radius of curvature are to be measured from pole to F in the opposite direction of the light. Therefore, it is negative. Now, for convex surface, here the focus will be there. As it is to be measured from P to F in the direction of light, therefore, it is positive. So, F is positive for convex surfaces, and F is negative for concave surfaces. Now, in the case of lenses, you have to measure the distances from the optical center. And all other rules are the same for this one. This corresponding to P, optical center is acting, rest of the things are same. Now F for convex lens. Suppose if the object is here, the ray passing parallel to the principal axis and it passes through the focus on the right side of the lens. Therefore, F is positive for convex again. And suppose if it is concave surface, then the ray will be diverged and then this will be the focus and this is optical center. So you have to measure this distance opposite to the direction of the light, therefore it is negative. So in both the convex lens and convex mirror, the focal length is positive, and concave mirror and concave lens, the concave lens and concave mirror, the F is negative. People will have a doubt. We derive any formula by using this sign convention. Now after obtaining the formula, again why to use the sign convention when we do the numericals? Actually, the sign conventions, because of the sign conventions, there we obtain a single formula for mirrors, spherical mirrors, that is 1 by V plus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F. And for lenses, 1 by V minus 1 by U is equal to 1 by F. These two formulae can be applied for any case, that is, this formula, single formula, can be applicable for any case provided you follow the sign conventions properly as per the given situation. Otherwise, we would have remembered several formulae for each convex lens, real image, one formula, convex lens, virtual image, another formula, like that, convex mirror, one formula, concave mirror, real one formula, concave mirror, virtual image, another formula, like that we have had many formulae. So to reduce that burden by applying this sign convention, we can have only one formula for mirrors and one formula for lens. Now the question, why do we substitute the sign conventions here? Actually, we derive in any formula after using the sign conventions. Now if you want to use the formula for the correct situation, we have to go back. So to go back to the original situation, we have to apply the sign conventions. Then only we will be doing the problem for that particular event. Otherwise, it is for any event, it cannot be fit into this one. So in numericals, you write the formula first and then you have to take care about the signs. Then only you will get the correct answers in any case. So now we talked about sign convention. This is new Cartesian sign convention. If you remember the graph paper, it is as good as this. Center origin is this, right side all positive, left side all negative, upside all positive, downside all negative. But in this case, the object should always be on the left hand side. But if you remember that the direction of light, if you measure the distances, then it is positive. If the measuring distances are in the opposite direction of light, then we have to take the negative. So remember, pole is the origin for mirrors and the optical center is the origin for lenses. So this is the new Cartesian sign conventions.